Right. Number 20 starts like this. Y minus 3x equals 1. First thing you ask us to do is solve for y. That means get y by itself. Get y on one side and everything else on the other side. Solve for y. So you can't say y is some number right off the bat. You're just getting y by itself. Allie?
Okay, do it.
Yeah.
Okay. So you would add 3x.
Right. Y equals 3x plus 1. Just writing it. The form we're going to get used to before long is y equals mx plus b. Okay, it's called the slope-intercept form. Why it's called the slope-intercept form will be more obvious as we go along. You may want to take some notes. So here we go. Y equals 3x plus 1. We solve for y. That's the first part that asks us to and then to graph. Alright, so many times over yesterday, we did this first. What do we do first?
Find
x and y in the first x that we used?
Zero.
Doesn't get any easier than zero. Okay, just a word to the wise. Your guys talking to each other and all that visiting, like, it's not helping you, and I'm tired of policing it. So if you want to do well, stop talking to each other, start paying attention to the math so that you know how to do the math, and then you can really do well in that. Okay? So we plug in 0 for x. 3 times 0, what's that?
0.
And plus 1 is?
1.
Cool. 0 for x, 1 for y. Cool? Alright. Need another x and a y. Sid?
2.
2. Okay, you can plug in 2. So we'll get 3 times 2 plus 1. That's 3 times 2 is 6 plus 1.
7.
7. Anything easier than 2?
1.
Oh no.
About 1. 3 times 1 is 3. Plus 1 is 4. So, whatever, now we have 3 points. The first one that was suggested is that we plug in 2 for x. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's what we got. So if that's if those are the 2 points that you found, well, that's enough, right? Yeah. That's enough to make a line, 2 points. So we're good. But if we found 1, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. What do you know? There it is.
What do you know?
Part of the same line. So if somebody found 0, 1, and 2, 7, and somebody else found 0, 1, and 2, 4, or sorry, 1, 4, it would be the same line. So some students may ask, well, how many points do I need to find? If you do your math perfectly every time, then just find 2. If sometimes you make mistakes in your math, maybe find 3, because finding 3 will help to spot any mistakes you may have made, right? Because if I find 3 points, and here's a point, and here's a point,
then something's
up. With these kinds of graphs, because these graphs are going to be lines. We've been graphing lines, and these are going to be lines, and if this is supposed to be a line, well, something's up. Either this point's too high, this point's too low, maybe this point is off, maybe all of them are off. So I just want to go back and check my math. If I get 3 points and they're all kind of not in a straight line, cool.
So like if it was like that, you just did math wrong?
Yeah, basically. Right now, at this time, when we're wrapping lines, yeah, since they're supposed to be in a straight line, these aren't. Something about your math is off. I would guess probably not this one, because this is what we get when we plug in 0 for x. I don't imagine any mistakes happening there. So I check my math on both of these guys. Okay. Oops. 21. Very similar, only solving for x is a little bit trickier. It's 2y equals 4. All right, so we're going to start by getting y by itself. Allie?
I'm going to subtract by the x.
Good. We're one step closer to having y by itself. Now it's just the y term on this side equals negative 5x plus 4.
Then Divide by 2.
Divide by 2, divide by 2. So y is equal to negative 5 halves x plus 2. Divide negative 5 by 2, divide 4 by 2. And we solve for y is by itself. Now we're going to graph by first doing what?
Putting 0 in for x.
0 in for x. And we plug in 0. Negative 5 halves times 0. What's negative 5 halves times
0,
Nicole?
0.
Negative 5 halves times 0?
Is 2, or is 2 because.
Wait. No, just this part. Just negative 5 halves times 0 is.
Oh, 0.
Plus 2.
Oh, it's 2.
It's 2, okay.
I thought you were
asking
me to solve
it. Just asking about that first. Okay. Great, that was in 2R. We found a point at 0, 2. 0, 2. Now we need to choose an x value, and I'm going to remind you something. You can plug any x value you want in there. You can plug in 0.72364592, but that's really inconvenient. It's not making the math very easy. Right? What number could I put here that would make this math, negative 5 halves times some number plus 2, particularly multiplying by a fraction, what would make that easy, Allie?
Times by 2.
Times 2. Let's see what happens when we do it 2. Okay, so negative 5 times 2 is negative 10 over 2 plus 2. What's nice about this 10 here? 10 can be divided by 2, right. So negative 10 divided by 2 is negative 5, plus 2, negative 3. So we plug in a 2, there you go, right? That's what we plug in for x, which is x over 2, got negative 3. 2, negative 3. There you go. All right, that. And again, just a helpful way to double check would be to just find more than 2 points. Just double check, you know, if they're all in a straight line, then you probably did it right. Allie?
Well, I'm like, I did 4 minus 5x.
Yeah.
That, and then I did 2 after I got it.
Oh, I see.
So, like, I put 4 minus 5 times 0,
mm-hmm.
and then divided that by 2 after I got it.
I mean, that'll. I imagine you got the same graph.
Yeah.
We are gonna move in this direction, writing equations like this, and never having it like over a number, right? A number times x, whether it be a fraction, negative, whatever, something times x, plus some number, right? That might be a negative number, so it might look like minus a number. So, while that works, 4 minus 5x over 2 is the same as negative 5x. Negative 5 halves x plus 2, say, just start to transition from this to that. There are certain patterns that come out that are useful when you write it down. Okay. So now I'm going to ask you to graph a line. Feel like we can do that?
Yeah.
I'm going to give you an equation, ask you to graph it.
Okay.
Put everything away then. Okay, so we're going to graph. We have the advantage of knowing that this graph is going to be what shape?
A line.
So we need how many points?
2.
2. If we're really good at finding our points, we can be confident in finding just 2. Sid, you want to help us find the first one?
Yeah. Let's go with
0. Let's go with 0 for x. That is really helpful. 5/3 times 0 is?
0.
Plus 2.
2.
Plus 2. 0, 2. And then Hallie. We're going to choose?
3.
Choose 3. Hallie, why are we choosing 3 for x?
Because it's divisible by 3.
Beautifully said. Because it's divisible by 3. Any other numbers that might work?
2.
9.
6.
Is 2 divisible by 3?
No.
Negative
2. 6. Negative 2 divisible by 3.
No. 30.
30. I heard 9, I heard
9.
6.
9.
Was that
120?
120, yes?
12.
All right, so all these numbers that I'm hearing, even negative 3, even negative numbers, which sound?
3,000.
3,000? Sure,
3,000. That
wasn't
me, that was
James. Bring it back. I'll bring it back. When we plug in something that's divisible by 3, that is easier. It's not right. It's something else like 2 or 1 or 5 is wrong. Those numbers are correct. It's just that only things that are divisible by 3 will, when we divide them by 3, come out to be a whole number. So this will come out to be 1. 5 times 1 is 5. Plus 2 is 7. Could have done 5 times 3 is 15. Divide by 3, you still get 5. Plus 2 is 7. So if I get 3, so we go over to an x of 3. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then there's our point. Notice I just went over 3. I just went over 3. And if I start from here, I really just need to go up 5. From there, just up 5 from there. Not crucial right now that you notice that pattern, but just pointing it out briefly. Okay. From this point, I moved to the right 3 because 3 is divisible by 3. And I only had to go up 5 from there. Not from here, but from this point. Over 3 and up 5. This is something to take note of. Okay. Graphing lines by choosing 0 for x, and then a number that what?
Is divisible by
3. Whatever the denominator is there, 3 or whatever it is.
I'm just on top of it today.
Killing it.